folks. Welcome back to Rule of Thumb. And you can see it's a little bit different view today because today I'm going to be making sourdough. Now, if any of you have been watching me for a while, you know I attempted to make a sourdough starter a while back when Heather at the Kneady Homesteader was doing her sourdough starter series, which I'll put a link for up above here. And I wasn't very successful, which had a lot to do with the fact that I have very little patience and my house is really cold. So I couldn't quite get the temperature where it needed to be and so on and so forth. And anyways, I threw in the towel. I was like, I can't do it. Well, I had seen Heather about a month or so ago, and she kindly gave me part of her starter, affectionately known as Walter, to bring home with me and see if I could make it work. And, you know, sure enough, it has. So last weekend, I made my first sourdough. It turned out beautifully. I was super happy with it. And Heather made it along with me, held my hand through the process. And we had so much fun doing it, we decided to do it again this Friday with a different recipe that I found in a book, called Bernard Clayton's Complete Book of Bread or something to that effect. If I can find it, I'll put the link down below. But I found a recipe that I thought was interesting. I sent it off to Heather. She modified the recipe, and that's what we're gonna make today. So, I just thought I would show you first what my starter looks like. See, it's beautifully happy. So, I fed this morning, and it's in the feeding growth cycle right now, which is when you want to use it. You don't want to wait till it's completely done. You want to catch it while it's feeding. So that's what we're going to do. So to that, I have a cast of ingredients here. I have one egg. I have 3 tablespoons of shortening. I have 2 teaspoons of yeast. Yes, we're going to add yeast to it. You don't have to, but we're gonna try it out to get some extra rise on it. I've got 1/4 cup of molasses. I've got 1 cup of a dark stout beer. I've got 1 tablespoon of salt and 2 heaping teaspoons of caraway seeds. I've got 1 cup of warm water over here. I've got my bread flour and my rye flour. So the first thing I'm gonna do is I am gonna measure out into my mixing bowl here. I'm using my Kitchenaid stand mixer. This is the KitchenAid 700 Pro Line series, I think it's called, and I will put a link to that down below as well. So I'm going to go ahead and measure my 200 grams of starter into this bowl and start with that, and then I will bring you folks back when we're ready to move on to the next step. Okay folks, we're back. So I have my 200 grams of starter in my bowl. To that, I'm gonna add my 1/4 cup of molasses. And I sprayed my container with a little nonstick spray in hopes that most of this would come out. And a lot of it did, but I'm also gonna grab a little scraper here and get the last of this out. Yeah, see that once I did that, then it came out pretty easily. So that's a little kitchen tip that I'm sure a lot of you have probably heard before, but never hurts to say it again. So if you spray your container with a little cooking spray when you're using something sticky, it'll come out easier. Okay, so I added the molasses. I'm going to add the 1 cup of warm water in there, and I'm going to add the yeast. Okay, and I'm going to go ahead and get the dough hook on my mixer, and I'm going to go ahead and just let this go for a second here, get this stuff mixed together. Okay, and then we're going to move on to the next part. So we want to do 2 cups of rye flour. To get my measuring cup here. All right, so I have my rye flour here. And I've got my little leveler is in the lid of my container, which I love. Alright. So we're just gonna scoop this and level it. And head right in there with that. And second one. So we're doing 2 cups of rye. And we're going to do anywhere between 2 and 4 cups of bread flour. We'll see as we start mixing it. So we got the rye flour in there. This little mix. Just to kind of start incorporating that. We're going to do the 3 tablespoons of lard. And 1 egg. And the cup of beer. Which I did let the beer come to room temperature as well. And then we'll add our salt and caraway. And you always want to do the salt last to keep the salt away from the yeast because the salt can kill the yeast. So we're going to go ahead and get this on a 2 and let this start mixing. And then we're going to start adding the bread flour. I do not have a setup where I can show you down into the bowl. So I'm going to periodically try and bring the camera up so you can see what it looks like from the bird's eye view. So I'll bring you back as this starts to mix together. Okay, folks, welcome back. I just wanted to show you, this is just starting to mix together. This is just the rye flour in here at this point. So I'm gonna go ahead and add the first cup of bread flour and let that start to incorporate. I'm sorry if this is a little shaky because I'm trying to hold you and add the flour at the same time. Alright, you can see that's starting to pull it in. We're going to go ahead and add a second cup. And then I'm going to let this mix and see how it starts to come together. And I'll bring you back when we're ready to move on and either add more flour or just let this knead. Okay, folks, so I did just shy of 4 cups of flour. And you can see where my dough ball is at. It's pulled away from the sides. I'm trying to see if I can get you at the best angle here. And I have now set a timer for 5 minutes. I'm going to let this knead for 5 minutes. And I'll bring you folks back in, between 5 and 7 minutes. I'll come back and show you folks what it looks like when it's ready to go. Okay, guys, we're back, and this has finished kneading. So I'm going to go ahead and take my dough hook off. Pop my bowl off. Sorry, it's a little shaky here because I got you on the same table. But I wanted to try and get you to be able to see what it looks like here. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and get this out of the bowl, give it a couple turns, get it into a dough ball, and then I will put a little oil in the bottom of this bowl and plop this back in there, and I will bring you folks back to see what it looks like when we get to that point. Okay, folks, that's what it looks like. I got it in a ball, in my bowl. I'm going to cover this with a warm, damp cloth. I'm going to put it on in my oven with the light on, and I'm going to let this proof for 1 hour, and then I will bring you folks back when we're at the next step. Okay, guys, welcome back, and you can see that this has definitely doubled in size. So let me go ahead and punch this down, and I am going to shape this, and then I will bring you back and show you what I ended up with. Okay, guys, welcome back. I had a little mishap. The bowl that I had the dough rising in, I had on the back of the stove, and I had my oven on, preheating, and it was too close to the back, and it essentially cooked the back half of the dough, or back, I shouldn't say half, maybe a third. So I took off the cooked part, I salvaged what I could, I shaped it into rolls instead of loaves, I let it rise, covered for another 40 minutes, I just brushed it with egg wash, I cut a little slit in the top, and now these are going into a 375 degree oven for 20 minutes, and I'll bring you folks back and show you what the end result is. Okay folks, welcome back, and there they are, the finished product. You can hear they sound good and hollow. See, they're nice and brown on the bottom. They're very hot. But they came out good. So salvaged from a near miss, but I think we're in good shape, and we will be having these with dinner tonight. So, like I said in the beginning, I am by no means a bread baking expert. I am learning as I go. So if you guys are interested in continuing on this journey with me and watching me as I make hopefully more successes than failures, let me know down below. And I can certainly continue to turn the camera on as I'm learning. If this is not something you're interested in, let me know and I'll skip it in the future. So, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please like, share, subscribe, come back and see me soon. And as always, I hope you had a great day.